Stephen Kilagi. Sorry, I haven't been. I've been busy the last couple of weeks. I've been busy trying to get my company back up. Been very busy hustling and getting my team back in order. Now, that's something that we all are facing in Papua New Guinea right now. It's a big financial crisis. But financial crisis in times like this is very important, and it's a good time for you to evaluate your company, see where you're wasting your money on, see where you have some staff that are not motivated, you can get rid of your excess fat. Those are the kind of things that you need to do to survive. Now, before I talk further, I wanted to talk to you guys about paradigms and mindsets in Papua New Guinea. A lot of people come and ask me, Steve, I want to start a business and I want to do this and I want to do this, but blah, blah, blah. And the biggest thing I see is their mindsets. They're too busy worrying about the family, too busy worrying about deaths in the village, too busy worrying about everything else except the business. They think a business is like a watermelon seed. You just plant it and it'll grow like them. It doesn't work that way. Take a business as like a one-day-old chicken. You've got to watch it carefully. You've got to put the light on it, put the heat on it. You've got to really spend time. If you really care about your business, you've got to spend time, love. You've got to keep on putting money into it and not expecting anything back. One big problem I see with a lot of Papua New Guinea businesses, we start a business, and then all of a sudden we see the cash flow coming in, say 10,000 a month, and we think, hey, me people a month in this. And then we have this mentality that we have to help everyone in the village. Every house cry, everyone's school fees, me people a man, me people a mere, I have got to maintain that. And that's why you see a lot of failed Papua New Guinea business. They don't know when to say no. So the idea of this video is to tell you, if you're listening right now, you don't have to give 10,000 kina in every house cry. You don't have to. There's no competition. It's just your own mind thinking that you have to impress everyone. As I keep on saying in all my videos, who gives a crap what people think? When I go to every house cry, it's 200 kina. Yes, 200 kina. There's no obligation for me to give 1,000 kina. There's no competition that I'm in. I don't feel pressure to do this. If you feel pressure to give 1 or 10,000 kina, hey, oba bagram name, let me got name to maintain. Those are mindsets that are set, like especially for Highlanders, young Highlander guys who are trying to set up. There's a big competition that, hey, me need to impress me. Me need to drop some money. This is all rubbish. You want to start a business, you got to be humble about it, and you got to put your business first. Even if your kids have to go to community school for the first 2 or 3 years, let them go to community school. You're going to have to take trips. All these kind of things are very important in the first 5 years when you're starting your business. So my tip when you're starting your business, be like the Chinaman. The Chinaman, they live in the store, they eat noodles, they eat soup, they do whatever they do. And in 10 years time, you see they expand because they're so disciplined. And that's where Papua New Guineans, we are disciplined people, but we're worried about our wantoks. We worry about everything else except the business. We're worried what other people will think of us. And that's the downfall for many Papua New Guinea businesses. We worry about everything else except the business. So in finishing this, please, if you're starting a business in PNG, no can worry lol wantok, your social obligation, your customary obligations, these are all bullshit. These are all your mindsets that you're born into. These are conditioned into your life. So what I'm saying is concentrate on your business and don't worry about customary obligations, deaths, all these other things. If you have adults in your family and they can't pay for the school fees, that's their problem. It's not your problem. It's not your business problem. Anything that's not related to your business, keep it out of your business. So I hope that helped you. If it doesn't help you, if you want to know more and want to have some more tips, I'll give it to you straight up. And just comment below, put your comments below. And please give me 2 thumbs up or 1 thumbs up. And also please subscribe on the corner. I'm Stephen Kilagi. I'll be coming up with more talks about business, a lot about mindsets, a lot about visions that a lot of us Papua New Guineans lack, in especially in doing business. Hopefully this really helped. Have a powerful week.